That's not a real headstone.
Sorry, not cool ghoul. I've got some grave news for you. I'm about to tie you to a pointy greystone with your own jacket.
It's a cagoule.
It's a what?
The type of jacket. It's a cagoule.
Fine. I'm about to tie you to a pointy gravestone by your own cagoule. Because it looks like I'm doing all the hard work for local lazy law enforcement, Officer Duncan's, as usual. And if you ask me, Greggy, which way did he go?
Huh?
Come on.
There he is! Go up!
Up where? Up a tree?
No, turn around and run straight ahead.
Take your next right and get ready to grab him. Sorry, I meant left.
Oh no, wait.
That's the robot. My mistake.
I found Not Cool Ghoul.
I'm not Cool Ghoul. This is Not Cool Ghoul's cagoule. And this mission has been an absolute disaster. Greggy, you're giving me bad intel. The robots stood there doing nothing. And Colin, you're turning up late and throwing a can of juice at me.
Well, you had Not Cool Ghoul and you let him go.
Yes, well, but the point is, we all need to learn to work better as a team. So, everyone back to HQ for a team working exercise.
Oh, man.
Could you help me up, please?
Affirmative.
Not by the head. Turbo Fantasy. That's me. Let me introduce you all to Fantasy Vigilantes, Turbo Edition. Growing up, this was always my favorite game.
Oh, so this is where you ripped off your dumb persona from.
No, I was inspired by it. Anyway, so this game is really difficult to beat on your own.
I've done it lots of times. It's easy.
Well, that's funny, because when you beat this particular game, mini pyrotechnics fire out the top. And I don't see any scorch marks on the wall here. But I do see scorch marks on the wall over there, where the game used to be, before we even met you.
Why are you so proud of your skid marks?
Scorch marks! Anyway, playing on your own, it's very difficult. But working as a team, we stand the chance. Okay, so remember...
I cannot reach the controls. My legs have seized up, and I am unable to bend them.
Okay, bend. Uh-oh.
My legs have collapsed. I will attempt to straighten them.
No, wait. Can you reach the buttons?
Affirmative.
Fantasy Vigilantes.
Okay, so, to successfully work as a team, we have to listen to what each other has to say. For example, I'll tell Greggy that he's hitting the jump button instead of attack.
Whoops! Hey, put me down! Oh, sorry. Listen to me when I tell you it was a complete accident.
Robot, we're all stuck here if you don't move right. No, I mean in the game.
I cannot maintain this position. Legs are straightening.
Just hold on a minute. I didn't mean physically hold on. I meant... Oh, for goodness sake!
Look, this strange dimension is somehow powering the game.
That's great, Greggy. But any idea how we're gonna get back down?
If we could generate propulsion...
Coming right up! Colin, grow up!
My feet can...
I don't want to hear any more about your feet or your legs. Just be quiet and don't let go. Wait, the mini pyrotechnics. Could they act as thrusters?
Oh, it's worth a shot.
Okay, now let's work as a team as if our lives depend on it. Because they do. Colin! I'd wait for it.
Look out behind you!
Kick him! Kick him! Leave him to me.
Should I pick that up?
No, let him take it.
Killed him. Dead.
Nice one.
Dead.
This is perfect. We're all listening to each other.
We did it! We worked as a team!
No, We didn't do it, Greggy. I had to do it all by myself because you two got bored and fell asleep.
Oh no, we're not still playing this stupid game.
Don't worry, Colin. We're never going to play it ever again. Robot, release us, then put this game somewhere where I don't even have to look at it. Oh.
Ow.
Did we know the robot could fly?
Oh, that must be what it was trying to tell us before you told it to be quiet.
Yep.
You know, if you'd taken your own advice about listening to your teammates, the robot would probably have flown us home.
Yep.
And when you shouted at me for farting, that was bad for team morale.
Shut up, Colin.
Would you like me to get the robot to bring your game back?
Yes, please.
The Ghoul Garbage!